Hello everyone, today we will see the emission control on IC engine. Okay, an internal combustion engine operates by burning of the fuel. Okay, they convert chemical energy into the mechanical energy. Okay, and from that the exhaust emission are the major contribution to the environment as a pollution. Okay, so from the combustion, if the combustion is complete, then the only products being produced from the exhaust would be water vapor, which is harmless, and the carbon dioxide, which is inert gas, and such as it is not directly harmful to the humans. Okay, however, if the combustion is incomplete, so combustion is not fully completed, then the more pollutant will be produced. Okay, the major pollution emitted from the exhaust due to the incomplete combustions are carbon monoxide, hydrocarbons, nitrogen oxides, means NOx, and the particulate matter PM. Okay, the main causes of emission are non-stoichiometric combustion, dissociation of nitrogen and the impurities in the fuel and the air. These are the main cause of the emissions from the combustion. Okay, the emission exhausted into the surrounding pollution and the atmosphere and caused the global warming, acid rain, smog, odor, and the reciprocally and other health hazards. As we see, the nowadays lockdown is going on. Okay, so many transportation and the vehicle are not running. Okay, so we see in the main city like Delhi, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, the pollution are much lesser than the before the lockdown. Okay, around 10-20% of the pollution are controlled or are in the level. So mostly pollution are generated by the vehicles. Okay, so now we will see the different methods of the control of the IC engine, emission control. Okay, so to need the control the emission from the automobiles give the rise to computerize of the automobile, hydrocarbons, carbon monoxide and the oxide of nitrogen are created during the combustion process and are emitted into the atmosphere from the tailpipe. Okay, the Clean Air Act of 1977 set limits as to amount of each of this pollution that could be emitted from the automobile. The manufacturer answer was the addition of certain pollution control devices and the creation of the self-adjusting engines. An oxygen sensor was installed in the exhaust system and would measure the fuel content of the exhaust stream. Okay, it then would send a signal to a microprocessor which would analyze the reading and operate the fuel mixing or air mixer device to create the proper air fuel ratio. Okay, so some methods which is used to control the emissions are methods and device for the emission control, engine design modification, treatment of exhaust gas, control of NOx, control of NOx, okay, controlling crankcase blow-by losses, means the positive crankcase ventilation system, PCV system, total emissive control system, and the catalytic converter and the thermal reactor. Now we will also the methods of controlling the emission from the CI engine. Okay, so in the CI engine, modification of CI engine to reduce the emission, control of smoke, and the control of the odor. Okay. So now we will see methods. Now we will see the methods to reduce the emission in the SI engines. Okay, methods to reduce the emission in the CI engine. Okay. So first is the catalytic converter. Okay, as we see, the catalytic converter is shown as a muffler. Okay, it is same as the muffler. Okay, the aim of the catalytic converter is to chemically treat the pollutants and convert them into the harmless gases like CO, means carbon monoxide, to the CO2, hydrocarbon to H3O, means HC to H2O, and the splitting of NO to N2 and the O2. Okay, so automotive emissions are controlled in the three ways. One is to promote more complete combustion so that there is the less byproduct. The second is to reintroduce the excessive hydrocarbons back into the engine for combustion, and the third is to provide the additional area to oxidation and the combustion to occur. This addition area is called as a catalytic converter. Okay, so the catalyst is the material which promotes or enhances chemical changes without entering into the chemical reaction. The materials which are used as a catalyst are platinum, palladium, rhodium, and iridium. Okay, so chemical reaction of the conversion of CO2 and HC to H2O, which normally take place at the temperature of 500 degree centigrade to 600 degree centigrade, occurs at 300 degree centigrade to 350 degree centigrade in the presence of the catalyst. Okay, this should as a sending air O2 to the exhaust may not convert CO and HC, as the air will be at the lowest temperature and the temperature of exhaust also comes down quickly while the passing through the exhaust tube from the exhaust manifold. So the platinum and the palladium are good catalysts for conversion of CO and HC, and rhodium is used for reduction of the NOx. So as we see the catalytic converter, okay, in figure, a tubular device integrated into the exhaust gas, means this device is integrated into the exhaust system. Okay, so catalytic converter filled with the thin walled mesh matrix. Okay, this is the mesh matrix. Okay, coated with the catalytics. That catalytics are that we already see that the platinum, palladium, and the rhodium. Okay, as the exhaust gas passes through this mesh, means when the exhaust gas passing through this mesh, this is the mesh type. Okay, so exhaust gas is enter from this area. Okay, means that exhaust are contained with the HC CO. Okay, so the HC and CO get converted into the H2O and the CO2. Okay, so this is, we can see that the carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, and the hydrogen is enter as a pollution in the catalytic converter, and that are converted into the H2O, CO2, and N2 and the O2. Okay, N2 and O2. Since all the three major pollutants, CO, HC, and NOx, are to be converted into the unharmful substance to wire mesh, one coated with the platinum and the other with the rhodium are used in converter, one converter only. Okay. So this is the catalytic converter. Next one is a positive PCV, positive crankcase ventilation system. Okay, the purpose of the positive crankcase ventilation system is to take the vapor produced in the crankcase during the normal combustion process and rehydrating them into the air fuel intake system to be burned during the combustion. Means, as we see in the figure, from here whichever vapors are produced in the crankcase, they are again redirected to the air fuel system. Okay, these vapors dilute the air fuel mixture. They have to be carefully controlled and metered so as not to affect the performance of the engine. So it will not be affect the performance of the engine. Okay, so due to the wear gap between the piston rings, in the crankcase ventilation, due to the wear and the gap between the piston rings and the cylinder is created, and the unburnt air fuel mixture from the combustion chamber leaks out to the crankcase. As we see from here, the unburnt air fuel mixture comes into the crankcase, from the combustion chamber. From this gap, this action is called by the blow by gas or blow by action. Okay, major portion of this blow by gases in the crankcase is at sea, means unburned fuel, hydrocarbons. Okay, these blow by gases are released to the atmosphere through the pipe from the crankcase called the bleeder. Okay, this is the bleeder hose. Okay, so it breed the death gases pipe and it is release these gases in the atmosphere. These blow by gases are recirculated to the combustion chamber for burning by connecting crankcase breeder into the intake manifold through the pipe and the wall combustion. Okay, so we can see this in the figure. So from here, the HC is such, and from that it is given to the from here to the air fuel system. Okay, it is given to the air fuel system. Next is a EGR system. Okay, we can called EGR as a exhaust gas recirculation system. So first we will see the purpose of exhaust gas recirculation valve is. Okay, the purpose of exhaust gas recirculation valve is to meter a small amount of exhaust gas into the intake system. This dilutes the air fuel mixture so as to the lower combustion chamber temperature. Excessive combustion chamber temperature creates the oxide of nitrogen, which is a major pollution. Okay, while the EGR valve is most effective method of controlling the oxide of nitrogen it's very designed to adversely affect the engine performance. Okay, so we will see how EGR system is work. Okay, now EGR system is used to reduce the pollution of the NOx. Okay, why? NOx produced by the combustion of the N2NO2 of the air at the higher temperature beyond the 1100 degree centigrade in the combustion chamber of the engine. Okay, the temperature in the combustion chamber is rise to maximum when the complete combustion take place during the acceleration of the engine. While moving on heavy loads or the climbing a slope, So the best way to reduce the pollution of NOx is to hold or control the maximum temperature below 1100 degree centigrade inside the combustion chamber. Okay. Since the exhaust gas contains mainly H2O and the vapor and the CO2, this further do not react with the O2. Hence, the EGR is circulate the exhaust gas, okay, which are at the lower temperature to combustion chamber through the inlet manifold in order to keep the peak temperature at low. Okay, this is reduce the production of NOx. Okay, first we will see the from the exhaust gas. Okay, this is the EGR valve. Okay, and this is the ECM sensor. Okay, so from the exhaust gas, this EGR valve is entering through the EGR valve to the intake manifold. Okay, so from here the exhaust is enter in through the EGR valve to the intake line. Okay, from this to this. Okay, the amount of exhaust to be circulated to the combustion chamber is so controlled, otherwise engine power will come down drastically. This is done by the EGR vacuum regulator. Okay, so this is the call as a EGR regulator, which is controlled by the ECU or the electronic control module. Okay, so this is the exhaust vapor sensor. Okay, the regulator restricts the exhaust gases recirculation when the load on the engine reduces and stop working at the no load. NOx is produced at the lower temperature. Okay, NOx only produced at the lower temperature, means when the engine is at the low load or when the engine is stop working, then the valve is closed. So this mechanism is from the Ford, okay, from vehicle. Next we will see the fuel evaporative emission control system, EVAP system. Okay, so first the gasoline is directly expelled to the atmosphere from the S engine. It escapes from the mouth of fuel tank while filling and also from the fuel tank breather due to the churning and the variation in the temperature. Okay, so gasoline evaporator quite easily in the past, this evaporative emission were vented into the atmosphere. 20% of all hydrocarbons emissions from the automobile are from the gas tanks. Okay, in 1970 legislation was passed prohibition of venting of gas tank fume into the atmosphere, and the evaporative control system was developed to eliminate these sources of pollution. Okay, the function of the fuel evaporative control system is to trap and store the evaporative emission from the gas tank, and the carburetor or charcoal canister is used to trap the fuel evaporator. Okay, so gasoline is also escaped from the float chamber of the carburetor, which is vented to the atmosphere. To arrest the escape of evaporating gasoline or the petrol from the fuel tank and the float chamber of the carburetor, they are connected by the means of tubing to the chamber filled with the charcoal where it is absorbed. Okay, where it is absorbed. When the engine runs, the collected petrol or gasoline is sucked round back by the carburetor and sent to combustion chamber for burning as shown in the figure. Okay, means we will see that here the check valve, okay, and this is the solenoid valve. This is the check valve of the fuel tank. This is the fuel filler tank. Okay, so evaporative means whatever evaporation of gasoline take place, okay, it is sucks from the where the evaporative gasoline are absorbed in this charcoal canister, and then it will be supplied to the catch tank. Okay, after when the engine is running, okay, so this storage gasoline is supplied to the intake manifold of the engine from here. Okay, next one is a air injection system. Since no internal combustion engine is 100% efficient, there will be always some unburned fuel in the exhaust gas. Okay, this increase the hydrocarbon emissions. To eliminate this source of emission, an air injection system was created. Okay, combustion required fuel, oxygen and the heat. Without any of these three, combustion cannot occur. Okay, without fuel, oxygen and heat, the combustion cannot be occur. Inside the exhaust manifold, there is sufficient heat to support the combustion. If we introduce some oxygen, then any unburnt fuel will be ignited. Okay, this combustion will not produce any power, but it will be reduced the excessive hydrocarbon emissions, unlike in the combustion chamber. Okay, this combustion is uncontrolled, so if the fuel content of the exhaust is excessive, explosion that sound like popping will occurs. So this is the air injection system. So next one is the modification is SI engine to reduce the emission. So a change in engine design to reduce and control those parameters which promotes the production of pollution, like compression ratio, combustion chamber, wall timing and the fuel supply system. Okay, so some modification are multi-point fuel injection system to completely replace the carburetor. Means by the carburetor there will be more combustion, it will be converted into the multi-point fuel injection system, which is called as a MPFI system. Okay, so electronics engine management to accurately regulate the fuel supply system to the cylinder by the sensing the various engine parameters. Okay, four valve system to replace the two valve system. Improper combustion chamber design and improved inlet manifold design for the axial stratification of charges. Okay, next one is a turbocharge and the turbocharge after cooler. Okay, so as we see in the turbocharger, okay, turbo compounded engine, they are founded to be up to 80% better than the conventional engine. Okay, also we can get the more power from the turbocharged engine. Use the ceramic components, low density and the silicon nitride SI 3 and 4. Okay, such as piston pins, valves, blades in the turbocharger. So these are the some types of modification in the SI engines to reduce the emission.